Hello everyone. Our next chapter is transitive and intransitive verbs. So before we proceed to transitive and intransitive verbs, you must know what is a verb. So what is a verb? Verb, these are the words that tell us the action done by the subject. Okay? So, verbs can be broken into two types, transitive verbs and intransitive verbs. So transitive verbs are the action verbs that have an object to receive that action. Means transitive verbs are those verbs that require a direct object to complete its meaning. Okay, they require a direct object to complete its meaning. For example, I baked some cookies. I baked some cookies. Here I is subject, baked is verb, cookies is direct object. And it answers the question what. Means I baked what. Okay, I baked what means it answers the question what. So intransitive verbs, intransitive verbs are action verbs, but unlike transitive verbs, they do not have an object receiving the action. Means intransitive verbs are those verbs that requires an object, that do not requires an object to complete its meaning. Fine. For example, she is sleeping. So here the meaning is clear that she is sleeping. We do not require a direct object to complete the sense. Next we have verbs of incomplete predication. Verbs of incomplete predication. So what do you mean by verbs of incomplete predication? It means that some intransitive verbs, as I told you, the meaning of what is the meaning of intransitive verbs? Intransitive verbs are those verbs that do not require an object to complete its meaning. So some intransitive verbs, they require a word or a phrase. They do not require an direct, they do not require a direct object, but they require a word or a phrase to complete the predicate and make sense of the sentence. Such verbs are called verbs of incomplete predication. For example, is, am, are, is, am, are, was, were, become, seems, taste, all these verbs are, etc. All these verbs are verbs of incomplete predication. For example, the man seems, what? The man seems happy. So here happy, it's an adjective. The man seems, how the man seems? The man seems happy. Happy is adjective here. And it is seems, it's our intransitive verb. Happy is an adjective here. So here it is a verb of incomplete predication. When we write here word happy, it makes the complete sense of this sentence. Fine. And the word that we used here, word or phrase that we used here to complete the meaning, that is known as complement. Okay, that is known as complement. Means the word that we used here to complete the sense of this intransitive verb of this sentence, that is known as complement of the verb. Fine. So this is the meaning of verbs of incomplete predication. So next we have direct object and indirect object. Okay. In a sentence, we have a direct object and indirect object. So, what is a direct object? Direct object, let's understand it with an example. So, the direct object is, for example, I made some coffee for you. So here I is the subject, we know made is a verb, we know, okay, coffee is a direct object. And I made a coffee for whom? I made a coffee for you. Okay. So here you is our indirect object. Fine. So this is the direct object, that is usually a thing. And indirect object, it is usually a person. Got it all of you? Direct object, it is usually a thing. And indirect object, it is usually a person. Fine. Let's take one more example of direct object and indirect object. Like they sent an email to me. So here is they sent an email. Right? They sent an email to whom? They sent an email to me. So here email, it is a direct object, that is usually a thing, and me is our indirect object, that is usually a person. So they sent an email to me. So we can say that it is a direct object, email is a direct object, and me is our indirect object. Fine.